And that's 80% power.
Hi, this is Yasmin from Tiger Robotics. Today we're using the 2x2 wind shaper and our smallest thrust stand to test how propeller performance changes with wind speed. Keep watching to find out how airspeed can affect propeller thrust, efficiency, and more.
We start by setting up our test in the flight stand software. We ensure our thrust stand and pressure sensor are connecting and collecting data. We identify and map our components, activate the ESC, and proceed to our automated test. We first measured the performance of the system in a no wind condition to get a baseline reading for our propulsion system. Now we will set up our wind shaper to get ready for our wind tests. Today we're using the web version of the wind control interface. We'll open the manual control page and enable control of the fan array. The 2x2 wind shaper has 36 fans in total and we'll activate them all for this test. We will set the fan power to 20%, which corresponds to 4.2 meters per second in these conditions. The wind will run at constant speed while the step test runs on the thrust stand. Now that the test sequence has finished, we will turn off the fans. We will now repeat the test at 40, 60, 80, and 100% wind power. Now that our tests are complete, let's have a look at our data. And if you find this video interesting, don't forget to subscribe. We will first look at how thrust generation changed with increasing airspeed. As you can see, thrust generation increased as throttle increased and was highest in the no wind condition at the highest throttle setting. For a given thrust level, propeller RPM increased as throttle input and airspeed increased. The wind from the wind shaper is responsible for the higher RPM, pushing on the propeller's blades and causing it to rotate even faster. Higher RPM is typically associated with higher thrust generation, but this is only true at constant airspeed. As airspeed increases, we observe a decrease in thrust generation. This occurs because thrust depends on the velocity difference between the air entering and exiting the propeller. When forward airspeed increases, the relative velocity at the inlet increases, but the exit velocity doesn't increase proportionally, resulting in lower thrust. Higher airspeed also changes the relative airflow angle. As the airspeed vector grows, the angle of attack on each blade decreases, which reduces lift and further reduces thrust generation. Propeller thrust also depends on the physical properties of the propeller, like diameter, pitch, and the pressure of the air flowing through the propeller disc area. Now, let's look at the thrust to power ratios at different airspeeds. This graph compares thrust and power at 9000 RPM across all the 6 airspeeds. As you can see, thrust drops steadily as airspeed rises from 0 to 17 meters per second. Meanwhile, the mechanical power required to spin the propeller decreases more gradually. Between 0 and 17 meters per second, thrust declines by about 75%, whereas power only drops by 19%. Because thrust falls much faster than power, the thrust to power ratio also declines with increasing airspeed. This translates into reduced propeller efficiency. Next, we'll look at propeller efficiency across airspeeds using two different methods. First approach, shown in the left graph, measures thrust in terms of grams of force per watt of mechanical power. This provides an intuitive metric for performance, but is not a true unitless measure of efficiency. The second approach, in the right graph, calculates efficiency as the ratio of available power to mechanical power expressed as a percentage. Here, available power is calculated as thrust multiplied by velocity, or airspeed in our case. At zero airspeed, this value is zero, so efficiency cannot be calculated. calculated. You can see that at low airspeeds, efficiency declines and then plateaus. At higher airspeeds, it increases before leveling off. So how can we apply this information to real-world drone operation? In practice, this data tells us that your drone will draw more power and be less efficient when flying at high speeds or against strong winds. Your battery will also drain faster and you'll have less endurance. A prop testing station with a wind tunnel is a great way to determine how your system will perform in specific conditions and how it can be optimized for improved efficiency. To learn more, visit the Tighter Robotics website. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and thank you for watching.